I don't necessarily know where to start other than I guess I'll begin with the big picture and a swig of go there. Ultimately, I am working to do a couple things. I'm working to begin capturing some of the things I find myself teaching and training some of my clients and the teams that they have on how to accelerate healthy leadership. And at the end of the day, the thing that I find that many of us haven't been taught, or many of us don't understand, is that essentially what we understand within behavioral psychology and just the behavioral sciences is that the way our brain works is fairly simple if you have the categorical eyes to see or understanding of it. And so I'm going to be speaking in general, broad brush strokes in a lot of ways, so that as many people as possible can comprehend the ideas or the thoughts. But I'm starting very narrow with the people that I know and the people I'm working with. So if you're not in my sphere of relationship, or we don't know each other, you didn't catch this video because I shared it with you, or somebody I'm working with did, would love to meet you. Please, reach out. I'll put all my contact information here. This is very much an endeavor of not I know more and you know less, or you know more and I know less. This is just I know different and you know different. And if we can put that together, magic typically happens. So I'm going to begin with a really big picture of leadership and start to share a couple of things that, number one, I see people working through from the standpoint of trends. And I think we don't do a great job as humans looking at the distinction between things that trend to happen regularly versus things that tend to happen. And so we can put too much emphasis on something when something tends to happen periodically and we think it's some big deal, versus if there's a trend or there's a perpetual thing that happens over and over and over in your life, we need to learn the difference between the signal of that trend versus the noise of something that tends to happen. So I'll get into that later, but I want to frame this from that standpoint. The second thing is, this is really low production value. I literally just got done with work today, had essentially the same conversation about three times. I particularly specialize in helping new executives accelerate their growth and their understanding. And so that gets us into this concept or this idea. I think I'm going to call this endeavor or this opportunity accelerating domain dominance, or maybe it's accelerated domain dominance, or maybe I'll simplify and just call it domain dominance. But the idea is, the way our brain works is there's a concept in the behavioral sciences of domain general and domain specific, or domain specificity. And I'm going to get into the domain specific. And here's the very simple overview of that concept. You may crush a certain domain. Let's call it your professional domain. You are an amazing boss. You're an amazing team member. You're an amazing worker. But then personally, your personal life, you suck as a husband, a father, a parent, a son, a daughter, an auntie, an uncle, whatever. And so the idea is, we want you to crush you. We want you to have a varied domain dominance across all the domains of life. And so if you oversimplify, and you can, I'm not here to split hairs. I'm here to add accelerated value in this particular level of domain dominance with the common denominator across all domains. And that is leadership. Leadership is the one thing that applies at every single domain. So when we think about it, if what I work to do is help people accelerate, because I had to learn the hard way, I want to accelerate someone's ability to have domain dominance with relationships, with family, with finances, with their vocation or their work, and so on and so forth. And so, in my estimation, probably Zig Ziglar did the most helpful job at working to clarify the domains, in my opinion. So we're going to work from an adapted variation of that and work through the various domains. Before we get to that, though, I need to lay some groundwork. And so that's how we're getting into this. And at the end of the day, I'm trusting that the content value is really helpful. And this is the longest video likely I'll ever do, I imagine. Because I'm qualifying it of why we're even here. But from a practical standpoint, we need to have some lenses or pillars or foundations, however you want to look at it, to really understand what leadership even means. So we'll get into the definition of leadership later, but we all have a general idea of leadership because probably as kids we played follow the leader, and we get it generally speaking. It's just most of us have a pretty terrible example of leadership in this day and age. Let's the first lens or the first concept to think through is the leadership spectrum. And I've heard the term thought leader for a long time now. I don't know, probably 2 decades. And for too long, I've thought, well, thought leader means what? Like, what is thought leadership compared to what? And I think in the last 5 years, the spectrum that has been helpful is really clarifying when we talk about leadership, what kind of leadership are we talking about? Are we talking about thought leadership or are we talking about action leadership? So when we're talking about action leadership, we're saying things that are focusing more on, say, like the day-to-day. We're focusing on things like, you know, let's say you have a boss at work and the boss says, hey, Anderson, I want you to do X, Y, and Z. And so I show up on time, mind you, and I say, okay, roger that, boss. I'll do X, I'll do Y, I'll do Z. The concept here is you are the technician. You are the one doing the work. You're the one swinging the hammer or getting something done. Versus the thought leader is someone who is really focused on having foresight, maybe. And so they're looking down the road, or they're looking at their communication. They're getting paid to communicate, or they might even be the ones delegating. So when we think about this, the concept of thought leader versus action leader is there is a difference in how you need to show up or what most value you can add to your organization. Now, here is what I find, is that most of us are in this realm. We land here at your first job and you're the laborer, the day laborer, the one executing. What we want to eventually do is get over to this side. Now, I don't typically like to think either ors, that's not necessarily the context we live in as much. This is one of the exceptions to that rule, where if you can start to think through where your focus needs to go, that's really what we're trying to do is make sure that your focus has clarity and direction. And so let's say we have a new leader, and as you're growing into an executive or a senior leadership role, or your job is to not necessarily show up and get something done, but rather help someone learn to get something done, really what we find is that someone may have, maybe your world in the beginning is a 60% action leadership, and then you should be 40% thought leadership. And so what that means is you need to know the work you need to be doing, how you need to be doing it, when you need to be switching gears. And as we find our ability to grow, so much of the time we can start to forget when we move out of this life stage. So we're no longer in the 60-40 split, but rather let's say that's inverted and we're now at the place where you should be doing something 40% of the time, where you're the one saying, model me, I'm on the front line working with you, to 60% of the time you should be thinking and thought processing and then communicating via a blog or a vlog or emails or that type of thing. So in sum, let's oversimplify this. So our brain has handles to wrap its mind around, or our mind around, so to speak. Action leadership is really working in the business. Thought leadership is working on the business. Or in other words, we could look at this as the ground war versus the air war. At the end of the day, we probably need some variation of both. But the thing we need to think through is if you can think through what your boss or your board or whomever is expecting of you, knowing the distinction of how you should show up will actually allow you the opportunity to make sure you're adding value in a more helpful way. So that's the leadership spectrum. Feel like I learned this the hard way. I'll probably post this on YouTube. I you know, now you can't dislike things. So please, if you disagree or you have a better thought process, let me know. I'll put all my contact information in there, or just write a response, you know, right there on YouTube. But what I want us to get going on is we've got to raise up leaders who aren't just aspiring as CEOs. And I coach a number of CEOs, and those CEO typically stands for Chief Entitlement Officer, as compared to we want a true chief executive who's modeling the things we need to do, who's leading by example. And I think this spectrum starts to help us move from entitlement to actual beneficial true leader that we want to follow. Trust this is helpful. Give me your feedback. Let's go.